Hello, I'm Professor Robin Shattock at Imperial College. I've worked on vaccines for over two decades and more recently on COVID-related vaccines. We anticipate that this will give people a broader response to the virus. And I suspect that everybody is fairly familiar with the fact that the virus is changing over time. And when you make an immune response to the original vaccine, it was very much focused on the first strain that came out in the pandemic, what we call the Wuhan strain initially, or the Alpha strain. By giving the immune system both the original vaccine and now combined with the Omicron strains, it's as if the immune system is seeing a wider diversity of targets. So it makes antibodies that are more effective as the virus likely continues to change over time. We know that that worked extremely well, and it's still working to prevent serious disease, and all the efficacy data is based on that original strain. So boosting that original response, as well as then inducing a wider immune response, is the best of both worlds. No, this new vaccine has an excellent safety record. Really, it's no different in terms of the side effects to the original Moderna and Pfizer vaccines, which have now been into many, many millions of people. So we really have an excellent understanding of the safety profile of both of these vaccines. It's definitely worth getting that booster, because with the updated vaccine, it's broadening your immune response. And even if the virus continues to change, you're going to be in a better position with having that wider immune response than if you are either relied on previous vaccination from some time ago or just had a single booster with the original vaccine. No, that worked extremely well, and there didn't seem to be any complication with giving both together, either in terms of safety or in terms of the immune response that was generated against the flu vaccine and generated against COVID. Doing the two things at once provides no negative outcome, and it's much more convenient to get both at the same time. Now, there have been an enormous number of studies showing the vaccine has absolutely no impact on fertility and is also safe in pregnancy and during breastfeeding. So I think people should be very reassured now. We really understand that it's safe for those groups. We have abundant evidence that it is safe. In the early stage, it wasn't recommended because people didn't have the evidence, and it wasn't because there was any indication that it was unsafe. It was really being cautious to make sure that we got the evidence to prove that the safety was there. And we now, it's now there. And so that's why it is now recommended during pregnancy. It's not so good at preventing transmission. It's good at preventing serious illness. Although we suspect that it reduces, even in people who have a mild infection, the amount of time that they are infectious. So if you are a healthcare worker, or if you're living with vulnerable people and you've had the vaccine, you're still, although you may get COVID, it may reduce the duration of your ability to transmit it on to others. We have strong evidence that it's very good at reducing severe disease. I think it's very likely that in years to come we will see booster campaigns for the elderly and for those with vulnerabilities and for healthcare staff and professionals that are working with vulnerable populations. So very much in line with flu vaccination. And that's why it's great news that you can give both together, and we're not having to ask people to come back twice, you know, once for a flu shot and then once for a COVID shot.